So you just got your brand new Oculus Quest and played it some Beat Saber.
Loser, loser.
It's fun, but now it's time for you to figure out how to use your Quest for showcasing your 360 or VR180 videos in the highest resolution and best image quality. This is the in-depth tutorial on showing you step-by-step on how to do just that. We will talk about the max resolution of the Oculus Quest. If you don't have time to watch the full tutorial, here is the cheat sheet for all the available max resolution. I will put it down in the description below, but don't go too fast just yet. Your current rendering workflow in Premiere or Final Cut Pro X might not generate the best video to leverage the new display on the Oculus Quest. If you want to know my Premiere setting for 360 and VR180 videos for Oculus Quest and a free workflow using FFmpeg, let's dive right in. Hey, what's up everybody, it's your boy Hugh here from CreatorUp. The brand new Oculus Quest is not only a great VR gaming device, but also a fantastic device to showcase your 360 or VR180 videos. Captured by camera like the Insta360 Titan, the Pro 2, the One X, the Candle Obsidian, GoPro Fusion, Views XR, and the list go on. The Quest uses Diamond Patel OLED panels as the display that are capable of delivering more vivid color. You can see the true black in Quest when in the Oculus Go LED display, you never get the true black. I'm not saying the Diamond Patel OLED panel is better than the LED display in the Oculus Go. In fact, there are many advantages in the Oculus Go that fell short in the Oculus Quest. For immersive videos, I will save that for the next review video. If you want to know why you should or should not get the Oculus Quest for immersive video, hit the subscribe button and find out in the next video. For those of you lucky enough to own the Oculus Quest, which, by the way, is sold out everywhere, here is again the max resolution for 360 monoscopic and 360 stereoscopic videos. This is the same resolution recommendation for Oculus Go according to my previous video right here. So yes, to answer your question, Oculus Quest does not have any max resolution increase at all compared to Oculus Go, except for one particular scenario. VR180 in top and bottom with codec HEVC or H.265. You cannot use H.265 in 5.7K, both mono or VR180 side by side. Only H.264 will work. We will talk about why you want to render in H.265 next. Just know it is a better codec for higher resolution with smaller file size. But if you are VR180 filmmakers and use camera like the Zcam K1 Pro, Insta360 Evo, or the View XR, they all capture in 5.7K. In Quest, you can render 2880x5760 in top and bottom format in H.265, which is the highest resolution and best compression codecs for all your VR180 lovers. Your next question is how? But before I show you how, I want to mention my independent test, not backed by the official Oculus recommendation, in 60 frames per second render on the Oculus Quest. There are issues in current Oculus Quest for 60 frames per second video because of the locked refresh rate of the headset, but it will be fixed soon by Oculus. To help you to see the 60 frames per second test result in the highest resolution possible, higher than the official Oculus recommendation, I provided my test render free for you to download and test on your Oculus Quest. From 30 frames per second to 60 frames per second with both H.264 and H.265. To see if my video has dropped frames in your Oculus Quest, you can enable develop mode and use the following command right here. With Oculus Gallery to see drop frame versus rendered frames. I am a scientist at heart, so I did the test for you and find out the max resolution without any drop frames in 60 frames per second is this. Go ahead, get a pen and write this down. This will be very, very helpful in the future. Trust me. So, the render quality on both the H.264 and H.265 is 70%. Wait, you ask, what is the bitrate? Well, don't worry about it. I will show you a non-premiere workflow to get the best quality without worrying too much bitrate. So keep watching. Now, let me give you a quick tutorial on how to sideload my test video into your Oculus Quest gallery. You need to download those videos and watch it yourself. And comment below if pushing past the Oculus recommended resolution has any real benefit in resolution. In theories, Oculus Quest has a higher resolution than the Go, but image quality is very subjective. So you tell me in the comment below after you watch my test videos. Here is the sideload instruction. Connect your Oculus Quest right here with the computer with your USB-C cable. By the way, no one seemed to mention one of the huge improvements of the Oculus Quest is the file transfer speed, thanks to the USB-C. Moving lots of video onto your Quest is like 10 times faster than the Go, which is a huge time saver if you're loading lots of videos all the time for testing. Another reason why you should get the Quest as an immersive video filmmakers. After your computer connects to your Quest, you need to wear your Oculus headset and authorize the connection each time, which is kind of annoying, but that's how you do it. Then you can just drop all the video files you downloaded from my YouTube link onto the movie folders. Now, for your own videos, make sure the naming is correct based on Oculus standard for 260 mono video and with -360. For 260 stereoscopic top and bottom video and your video with -360-TB. For VR180 video, side by side or top and bottom, just end with -180-3B. So Oculus Gallery will play your video with the correct projection. So now, put on your Oculus Quest, go to Oculus Gallery. Besides sideload your video using the USB-C cable, as you see here, you can also set up a media server on your PC to drop video directly via your home network. Go to internal storage. Now you see all the videos here. In order to see the file's name, click the list icon on the top left corners so you know which version of the video you are watching. I highly, highly recommend you to check out the VR180 version, which is in vertical 2880x5760, the 5.7K in H.265, shot with the Zcam K1 Pro in Star 260 Evo and the View XR. You see the Quest indeed look great for VR180 with max resolution render. Okay, now you know how to sideload and watch immersive video with the Oculus Quest. Let's jump back to reality and let me show you how to render the best quality immersive videos for your Quest. Now, open Adobe Premiere for your finished master video file. They should be in .mov container with ProRes 422, Cineform or DNxHR if you're on a PC. If you don't know how to edit 360 or VR180 video to get to the master video file, please check out my other Premiere tutorials. If you are not using Premiere, don't worry. I will show you a better and free way to render perfect video for the Quest. But I want to show you why Premiere is not up for the task just yet. Now, select the timeline and hit Ctrl C on your keyboard to bring out your render windows. So, I would not suggest using the Premiere rendering engine for the Quest at least. Because I don't really know what Premiere does to my video. For H.264 render, there is speculation that Premiere is using YUV TV range instead of the full range color for your final render. Which means for your already limited 8-bit color, you only get range from 16 to 235 instead of the full range 0 to 255. So that's why black is not true black and kind of look grayish. Everyone is so worried about the resolution and never pay attention to the color depth, which is equally important if not more important than resolution. Especially for the Quest. And for HEVC or H.265 render with Premiere, I don't know about you, but for my machine, which is top of the line, it's extremely slow compared to H.264 within Premiere. I think there is a bug somewhere in the version, but I just don't know. So, to avoid all this confusion, I will use a third-party plugin called AfterCodecs, which use the latest FFmpeg to help me define the correct rendering setting. And here is how. Pick container as MP4 and then pick open AfterCodecs setting in here. Go ahead and hit the open AfterCodecs setting right here. As you see, in AfterCodecs, you can pick H.264, which is based on X264 with the FFmpeg, and also you can pick H.265 with the HEVC codec. If you pick H.264, in here, you can set from TV range to full range. I will recommend it, you always pick full range to get the full color depth. In the quality part, you can pick quality, bitrate, and file size. The easy way to define is actually not use bitrate, it's actually using quality. So usually I will set the quality 70, that's good enough. So sometimes we'll have bitrate about 30 megabit per second to 50 megabit per second, depend on your videos, to make sure the distribution size is small. And then at the end, make sure you put on the VR meta. If this is a mono video, put VR mono, it's stereoscopic. You can do stereoscopic top and bottom right here for the YouTube format. And then you go ahead and hit OK. And in here, you set the width and height. This is a 60 frame per second video, but you can drop it down to 30 frame per second if you want to. And then go ahead and hit export. Same idea for H.265, you just go ahead and pick H.265. Again, I usually keep my quality 70. And H.265 actually will keep the same quality as your H.264, but with a smaller file size, which is better for distribution on the Oculus Quest headset. In here, again, make sure you pick full range, not TV range. And pick the meta you want to. Then go ahead and hit OK. Okay, now you know how to use AfterCodecs to render from Premiere. The only thing is, AfterCodecs is not free. Although I highly recommend just to save yourself some headache, especially if Premiere is your editing software. AfterCodecs is extremely fast with Premiere or Media Encoder. But for those of you who want to do it yourself for free or just not using Premiere at all, here is the FFmpeg way to render the best video for Quest. This is not a FFmpeg tutorial, but I will make one soon to cover everything you need to know on using FFmpeg for 360 video rendering. Today, I will only focus on the Quest render. Install FFmpeg on your PC or Mac. Open terminal or command prompt on PC like right here, navigate to your video render folder like so, and drag and drop the location after CD to navigate to the render folder. By the way, to know if you have FFmpeg correctly installed in your system, type FFmpeg-version to make sure you see this. Then copy and paste this command right here, and I will walk you through this command right now. So for this command right here, copy and paste from the description first, and then you can replace your input video of your video file name, like for example right here. My video file name is minecrafttest.com, so I just go ahead and copy that. Move my cursor all the way into this quotation mark, replace the input.mov into my video.mov. Do you see this one? Meaning that I'm using the H265 videos. And then this is the quality. I would suggest around 18 to 21 will be really good. And the scale is your video size. So if your input video is not this size, it's bigger. So you want to put in the scale size right here. Here is very important. Remember, I just mentioned about the full range and the TV range. So make sure you hit full right here. And then make sure that you use the YUVJ420p right here. That is a hack for the current FFmpeg library to get the full range video. And then aspect ratio for this video is stereoscopic 1:1. So it's square. And then this is the output video name. So you can name it whatever you want. And that's it. And then go ahead and hit enter. And we'll start encoding right now, right here. And here you can see how many frame and the speed and every stack right here. For VR180, let's assume you follow my VR180 workflow and get your master video file in side-by-side VR180 format in at least 5.7K. This is the command to convert them for max resolution in H.265 inside the Quest. So again, copy and paste in this command, and right here is the input file name. Here again is 265 library. Here is the quality, and here is the important part. We gotta flag this as a stereo 3D from a side by side 2:1 ratio. Convert it into top and bottom ratio. And the scale, we use the max resolution of the Quest, which is 2880x5760 with full range. And then aspect ratio is 1:2. And then here is output file name. I only show you H.265 command here because I think H.265 gives you the best image quality with the smallest file size for distribution. Again, if you need help on installing FFmpeg and use it for H.264, comment below and I will make a follow-up tutorial on how to use FFmpeg in both PC and Mac. Whew! That is a long tutorial and not as fun as playing Beat Saber with the Quest. But now, hopefully, you have your best VR works in your brand new Oculus Quest and ready to show your next client meeting. Impress them with your quality hard work so you can get paid and buy more Beat Saber songs or other VR games for your Oculus Quest. Hit me up if you want to play some VR game together. Comment below what you want to learn next regarding of your Oculus Quest for productivity works. I am not a VR gamer, but I will help you to maximize your Quest investment for sure. The next tutorial is my official review of the Quest compared to the Oculus Go right here. If you have not bought the Quest yet, hey, hold on. Wait for my review before you pull the trigger. You might be surprised by what I have to say. As always, stay creative in VR, and I will see you next time. VR Creator Level Up on Creator Up.